teaching ability. We are very happy that all of you have gathered here for this long-awaited seminar, and I hope you make the most of it. Now I would like to introduce our keynote speaker of this session, Mr. Tanveer Mohammad Haider Ali. He is an associate professor of finance and banking department and a PhD researcher of the University of Chittagong. He is also an adjunct faculty of East Delta University. He received his master's in international business management from Thames Valley University and both MBA and BBA from University of Chittagong. He conducted various courses in Bangladesh and United Kingdom. He is the founder of Green Society Bangladesh and author of Liquidity Problems of Small Enterprise. I would like to call Mr. Tanveer Mohammad Haider Arif sir on the stage to speak his words on today's session.
Thank you so much. This is my immense pleasure to speak in front of you. Though I have a long connection with East Delta University, but I'm talking like this in front of you is for the first time. So again, it's really a milestone step from my side. I'm taking classes regularly. I'm coming as guest, as a tutor. Sometimes we are participating in so many events as participants, sometimes as judges. But as an expert, I'm talking about this for the first time in front of East Delta University participants. Just I'll draw your attention regarding the title of this session, Business Case Analysis, Some Critical Insights. Critical Insights. So if you have this quality with you, then all of you have the capabilities to become a good analyst. Critical insight. What does it mean? If you say, to this presenter, Mr. Tanveer is not good at all. This is good analysis. But if you can prove that he is not good at all, why he is not good at all, and if you clarify this, why you don't like him with a lot of logics, with the statistics, then you can say that you have the quality of critical analysis. So case analysis is for those who can analyze any business situation, any problems, critical. So before I start my formal discussion, I'm drawing your attention again regarding critical analysis. Critical, what does it mean? You know the good manager, if they walk here for 5 minutes, a good manager walks here for 5 minutes, he or she can identify so many problems. And if the manager is not good enough and walks for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, because you will never be able to find out any problem here. So the good manager is a critical analyst. So when you are given so many problems in front of you, you are given income statement or balance sheet, you are given marketing problems, you are given management problems, you are given financial problems, or you are given the whole scenario of a business enterprise. And if you read, you don't have the quality of critical analysis, then you will be just a reader. You will never find where are the problems. You read several times, you have seen that. Several times you read 3-4 pages and found nothing. Why? Because we are not critical analyst. So how can we become a critical analyst? How can we become a critical analyst? We have to ask millions of questions ourselves. And if you are a very good question maker, first, if you are very good question makers, and then try to find out answers yourselves, and from all the answers, if you can find out the best answers, then you'll be able to analyze critically. So again, come to the point, your friend is a very good one. If you just say he's a good one, you are an analyst. And if you can prove that he's a good one, then you are a critical analyst. Now see, next slide please. You see, so many marks are here. But before that, do you know when case analysis started? And who started this? Case analysis started in 1920s. And who? Harvard Graduate School of Business Administration in 1920. So 1920s, what Harvard Business School started, we're still trying to practice this. We're still trying to incorporate case analysis as a part of our study. We are behind. Right now, it's a good initiative for the Eastern University, authorities, faculties, and also for the student that you have started. So why? Why do we go for case analysis? Why? Is it really important? Is it really essential? Why? Because case analysis will give you an opportunity. What kind of opportunity? Opportunity to develop, sharpen, and test your analytical skills. So why case analysis? Because it will make a bridge to reduce the gap between your classes and practice, theories and practice, classroom study and outside world. So there's a gap. So many times our students, they ask, and so why you are requesting us to study? We don't find the relationship between theory and practice. This is not true. There are always a relationship between theory and practice. If you really can make a link between theory and practice. Now, we're talking about analytical skills. On what? What are the fields that you can have analytical skills through the process of case analysis? These all are known to you. You see, you are able to assessing situations. You are able to assessing situations. Number two, sorting out and organizing key information. Once you know, you can still sorting out, but sometimes you are not following the sequence, and that's a big problem. Even we have found that after completing Bachelor of Business Administration, 90% of students failed to draw SWOT analysis. 90%. Some of you think that I'm joking. 90%. We made the survey and we found that our student, after completing Bachelor of Business Administration, 90% failed to draw a good SWOT analysis. They have written all their strengths as opportunities. All the opportunities as a strength. All the threats as weaknesses, and all the weaknesses as threats. Why? It's because they were completely unable to find out the difference between strength and opportunities, weaknesses and threats. They never set the relationship. They just oversaw strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Asking the right questions. If you're really good about case analysis, you can ask the right questions. You'll be able to define opportunities and problems. You'll be able to identify and evaluate contaminated courses of actions. Why you go for case analysis? Just to give a solution what is already available in the case? It is a reading comprehension. And we have seen that some students rate cases as reading comprehension.
Yeah.
They read again and again and again, 3 to 4 times, and then try to find out all the answers from the cases. They thought that answer also given in the cases. Like this. Sometimes even the problems will not be given in the case. You have to read, and then try to find out what are the problems. You have to give the solutions. You may be able to interpret data. You may be able to evaluate the results of first strategies. You may be able to develop and defend new strategies. You may be able to interact with other managers. You may be able to make decisions under conditions of uncertainty, and you'll be able to critically evaluate the work of others, and then be able to responding to criticism. So we have found good case presenter, but they have limitations of responding to criticism, the last stage. So they lose their strength. They are unable to answer all the questions because they didn't go to the process. So see, these are what kind of objectives as well. You can say these are the objectives of today's session, but I didn't say these are the objectives. I say that once you are able to analyze case, you have the quality to become a critical analyst, and you can find out the problems and provide best solutions of any organization's problems. It means you are good in this. So these are the skills. You can achieve these skills. So if you are really attentive, if you go through the process, if you follow the sequence, and then you will have all these skills. How many of you have ideas about this?
Strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats.
Boston Consulting Group Matrix?
Yes, sir.
Space? Or any other? So strategies describe when the organization follows some strategies that is classical or maybe modern, but they have their own strategies. Now you have to evaluate all the strategies, what are they following, and whether they are really following the best strategies or they are behind their competitors. What should be the right strategies for them? You have to suggest if you are really good in case study. You can earn millions of dollars. You believe that? If you are a very good case analyst, you can earn millions of dollars. Even in Bangladesh, you cannot. Even our university teachers are running. One man, they're working with the Bombardier Aviation, and this project was totally designed by the university professors. So they work on their problems, they provided some solutions, and based on those solutions, the bank started USP. What's the third one? Challenges. Challenges. Bangladesh is facing challenges. What sort of challenges? Lot of challenges. What's wrong? So you see, when you say a lot of challenges, then you are an analyst. But if you can identify rightly what are the challenges we need to bring out in front of the analyst, and if you can, and then provide some recommendations, suggestions to overcome all those challenges, means you have already entered into the case of the country and you are becoming a case analyst. And the fourth one, outcomes. You'll be given income statement, balance sheet, so many statistics, result, their profitability is increasing or decreasing, liquidity problems arises or not, their market performance is declining, they're not doing well in the stock market. So all these kinds of outcomes will be given. And then outcomes oriented, accomplishment, changes, lessons learned. So I request it, don't remember this. Move forward. Yeah. What's the second one? So remember, I'm interested in forget this. Because through these sessions, we'll have millions of questions. I mentioned earlier that if you can make millions of questions, only then you will be a good analyst. What analyst? Who can make millions of questions? If I read 10 sentences million times, I'm unable to ask questions. But there are so many analysts who read once and can ask themselves millions of questions from 10 sentences. And then they provide millions of solutions. And then again from millions of solutions, then find out which one is the best and one that proved that. And the organization implement this decision and pay $1 billion to the person who provided this solution. You don't believe that? It's happening in Bangladesh. It's just for IB. It is a task for you guys. And I will take a break. IB, do you mind it? IB, I don't want to see that you read this movie. Just put dance and write and take a picture. These are the business case principles. And whenever you go for any sort of analysis, you must remember these principles. These principles. And if you want to participate in any competition, you still have to remember these principles. Because if you know all the principles, then you have a good chance to cross the limit. And so many cases we find solutions from our participants. Do you know what kind of solutions? All the solutions are coming from Mongol Group. Why? Because they don't know the principles. You cannot give any sort of suggestions what is not really relevant to the organization. Yes, your suggestion is really brilliant. But you have to remember the capabilities of the organization, whether they can achieve it or not. They can implement it or not. And that's why these are the principles. The first one, decisions are made relative to all the needs. You see that we have the habit, if we look for a solution from our students, then give the solution in instant. They have ready solution. So the first principle is you cannot do this. You must provide all the alternatives, and then you have to provide the best among the alternatives. We want to see that how many alternative solutions you have, and among the alternatives, you say what is the best. Why you have said that this is the best? The first principle, decisions are made related to alternatives. Not only one decision, and you say that this is the best. You cannot select this. You see the first principle? So you must have some alternative solutions. Even if you don't have time, at least 2-3 alternative solutions you have. And among these 2-3, you have to prove that one is the best. Another one is the alternative. The second, impossible, use money as the common denominator. If it is marketing management case, if it is strategic management case. So marketing management, strategic management, is still, we love to see that money is coming. If you have time, if you have 5 minutes time, you can prove that your product policy will increase your revenue, your pricing policy will increase their revenue, you'll be the best. So if you give a solution, if you say that, oh, it is a time to price penetration, it is a time to product penetration, and if you cannot prove that, after taking product penetration strategy, what percent of the revenue is going to increase, then maybe your suggestion is a good suggestion, but no one will be interested because money is a you agree with this? Why don't you start a debate? Why don't you say, you blame me that, oh, without money, we can also provide consultation. No? Third one, some costs are irrelevant. Oh, Bangladesh, a country, we are busy with our first. Gotu-dal-ke-ka-bhul-ku-re-si. গত মাসে একটা ভুল করেছিলাম, শিক্ষক এখনো বুঝতে পারেনি, and at the time of analyzing your case, some costs are irrelevant. Means the cost already incurred, and you cannot overcome the situation. You should not spend your time for this. Some costs are irrelevant. যেগুলো হয়ে গেছে, যেগুলো চেষ্টা করেও ওভারকাম করা যাবে না, সব চেষ্টা করলেও একান্ত we should not spend time for this. You see that? It's a good principle. Some cost, you have already paid the rent. And what test that will do, rent for your bottom. You should not spend your time for this. You can spend for future rent. You can design a new policy for future rent. What you have already paid, you should not spend all the time for this. Investment decision should recognize the time of money. Nowadays, we say any investment decision, any sort of investment decision without time of money consideration is irrelevant. And in case of Bangladesh, it's too irrelevant because our today's taka is fluctuating so fast that tomorrow you cannot buy even 50% what you can buy today. You have idea about Tangalore money? Tangalore